The raw data is like this. We have date, product, whether it came in or went out, and the quantity. The out quantity is negative. The report we want is date, product, and the opening and closing balances. So let's see how to go about building this report. The first step of adding this data into data model. So the table is already in the file. I'm going to go to Power Pivot and say add to data model. In real life, please do not do this. Keep the raw data separate, create a blank new Excel file and import it using data, get data from file, Excel or whatever the raw data is. And now the data is in data model. We're not going to do anything here. We're not going to use a date table. Now, what are we really trying to do? I'm going to filter it on one product so that it's easier to understand. Multiple dates are here. So let's take one day, one product at a time and understand what happens. So we have four things which happened on first day. Opening balance for everything is zero because we have nothing in hand. So it came three times and went out. So the closing balance is two. So actually this is basically sort of a running total. So now the closing balance is again two because one came, one went. If it was only closing balance, we could have just used a simple pivot table, running total, and it would work. Now, in order to understand the opening balance, what do I have to do? I have to take the starting date, which is 8. Starting date, ending date same, then opening balance is 0. But if starting and ending date is different, total is the closing balance. But starting and ending date minus 1, what is the total? That's the opening balance. So that is the tricky calculation we have to manage. In a pivot table, we are going to put the date and product. So now for each date and each product, I need to know the first date and last date. Once I have that, I'll figure out what was the total of all the transactions within this date, and that becomes closing balance. You will see that the closing balance of a day becomes the opening balance of the next day. First, we have to find the first date and last date. Now let's do the last date. It's easier. Last date, there is a function called last date. Last date of what? Table 1 date. Now you'll say table 1 date, it'll always give me the actual last date. No. For every row, it is getting filtered by whatever is there. So it will give me the correct last date. And then I have formatted it. First date is simple. I want the first date in the entire table. So I just say all and the date, so that any filter is removed. First date remains the same and last date changes. Now is the time to calculate the closing balance. What is the function? Calculate and sum of quantity, obviously. And now we have first date and last date, right? So we are going to take dates between function. Dates between function ask me which date column. We have only one. And what is the start date and what is the end date? Then it figures out what to do. And that's how you get the closing balance. You can see it here. The opening balance in the first item, first date and last date will be same. So if it is same, I'm just returning blank. Otherwise, it is the same function almost, except the last date is last date minus one. And then you drag date and product into the row area, opening and closing balance in the value area. And just for understanding purpose, I put F date and L date. You don't really need them. You can even hide them so that you only see the required values. So that is how you calculate opening and closing balance. If you have any questions or if you know a better way of doing it, let me know in the comments. That's it for now. Thank you.